The roof is open today at the Krokyo Dome here in Tokyo, Japan. The only city to survive World War VII. Tokyo saved the Earth with their giant robots and monsters. Now they'll thrill the universe with their regular-sized robots. Today's matchup promises severed limbs and ruined careers. The Microhard Mutilators face off against the Tokyo Terminators. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. And MFL Game Day is on the air. Grim Blitzrow and my partner Brickhead Mulligan and Mini Bricks. Heard you got a little touch of the mutant bird and pig flu. How you feeling, partner?
Well, the projectile vomiting finally let up, but the monsoon mudslides have begun. If you know what I mean.
I've been literally cramping his brains out all night. He's getting stupider by the hour, if that's even possible.
And he gets 3 yards on that run. Second down and 7. A great throw and a great catch. But sadly, man, what a hit that was.
Hey, man, nobody can touch you with an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about, huh?
And it's first and 10.
Not one, not two, not...
The quarterback goes down. Zoom on his face. I want to see if he's crying. Second down and long.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
The QB looks angry at his offensive line, and I can't blame him. Third down, and the punter is warming up.
Hot one, hot two.
Oh, great pass on that play. They caught the defense napping. I'd be impressed if he splits the uprights from this far away, Bricks.
If he doesn't, they're gonna split his skull wide open.
Good.
You know, Grim, in this league where murder and bribery are cheered, it's good to be good, huh? I mean, can we all just...
Not this shit again. Bricks, I'm stopping it right there.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
It's a 4-yard gain. And it's first and 10. Now I've had it. I'm running out of excuses for this QB. Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
The greatest. No, you didn't see that because I'm too fast.
And it's first and 10.
Hot one.
And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. For 9 on that play. And that'll bring up second and one.
Hot, hot one, hot two, hot, hot two.
And this guy is supercharged with electricity. Man, he just laid the wood on him on that one and knocked the ball out. The defense comes. His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. And they're catching up.
Joke, chop, do something. That is such bullshit. This game is fucking rigged. I tell you, the programmers are speeding up the defense. I'm gonna write an email to that fucker.
And it's first and ten. And the defense goes for the jugular and rushes to... And the whistle blows the play dead, along with the quarterback. And it's first and ten. A run for no gain. Second down and 10. If you don't hear it coming, quarterback passes for a touchdown. Why is it that no one can score in this league without showboating? Man, are these guys greedy or desperate? Either way, they're going for two. Ah, and he lateral, and he gets into the end zone for the conversion. Home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! And it's first and ten.
Hot, hot one, hot two, hot.
Not going to drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. And it's first and ten.
Hot, hot one, hot two, hot.
And he'll pick up the first down with a nice piece. Oh, come on, that was a cheap shot. That's why I love this guy. And so are the fans. And it's first and ten.
Hot, hot one, hot two.
The QB is dinking and dunking the defense to sleep. 1 yard on that pass. Second down and nine.
Hot, hot one, hot two, hot, 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 hot.
He blasts it and picks up 7 yards right there. Third and two.
Hot. Hot one, hot two, hot, hot,
hot. Oh, what a sack there. I heard this guy likes to play with soft balls. He's going to play with crushed balls from here on out. For a kick this far, you just gotta kick it as hard as you can, partner.
And aim! It's really important from this distance.
It's probably a smart idea. Straight through the uprights. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's first and ten. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. First down and forever. And they run it for a couple of yards. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. And another, oh, with a punishing hit. First and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
And the defense gives up 5 yards there. Second down and five.
Hot one, hot two.
He was stuffed at the line of scrimmage.
So was that cheerleader.
And we've got a tight battle here as quarter one comes to an end. Third down and five.
Hot one, hot two.
Caught for the first down. And it's first and ten. First and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
I'll say this, they're putting together a hell of a drive. First down and one. And he rumbles into the end zone for the score.
I hope he's not gonna dance.
I don't remember that being an officially sanctioned MFL rule. And they've had enough. The offense jumps off sides and attacks the ref. First down in a mile.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yawn.
Second down in a mile. And, oh, you knew you were going to see a lot of carnage today, folks. These teams have bad blood between them. Apparently, they got it from the same bloodmobile that usually parks outside next to the taco truck. Raccoon rabies blood is my thought. Always a player's favorite. Third down and long. And into the end zone for a touchdown. Once he got his hands on that pass, he was on to the races. Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
Are you proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm Threads. Their marketing team hates it.
And it's first and 10. Not much there, maybe a yard. Oh, and you can bury that guy because he is dead.
Oh, did you see what number he was? I gotta check it off my dead mutant bingo card. I only need one more.
And it's first and 10. And the MFL keeps pounding out the death hits on WMFL 98.8, the greatest hits of all time.
Huh? Did you just say greatest hits? Where?
And the offense has only two running backs left, and the defense is licking their lips.
I think they want to hit those last two runners for this outfit.
And it's first and 10. Picks up maybe a deuce at most.
Speaking of deuces, I gotta, hey, you got a dollar for the bathroom attendant? He threatened me if I didn't tip him next time.
He is, with the vicious kill.
Did you know light hits are one of the leading causes of death for mutants over 25?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, right below attending bachelor parties and owning a Sam Schwan Galaxy phone.
Play. Second down and 5. And this guy just blew up and he's on fire. I'm not talking about one of those video game fire modes. And now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. And it's first and 10. And chainsaws roll. And say goodnight to that guy, Brent.
Bingo! Bingo! I just hit that mutant bingo! And all I was missing was his number for the last three plays! Talk about luck!
Second down and 5. Shoveled his feet so well on that play, he should go to lost weight. And it looks like we've got a penalty here. And it's first and 10. Pass play nets them 7 yards.
Oh, no. I got the hiccups. bugs again. What are you supposed to do to get rid of them again?
You stick it in a plastic bag, say the alphabet backwards while you set yourself on fire, and jump out the window. It ought to stop them.
Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day, because he's the one who just got wiped out.
First down and six. And that pass is good for about 5 yards. The warning sounds, only 2 minutes left in the first half. And that'll bring up second and one. Touchdown! Oh, he ran through those defenders like a greased turkey. And they come to the line trying to tie this up with 2 points.
And if they don't, things are gonna get...
And the ball is left. Bam! Gutsy run for the conversion. Never get into a dance-off with a robot. They're programmed to perfectly execute dance moves with just the right amount of sass. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. They're going to be able to return this one. And it's first and 10.
Air ball! Hey, did we start letting ghosts into the MFL, Grim?
No, that was just a shitty pass to absolutely no one. I'm going to say maybe 3 yards, but a tough 3 yards. And that'll bring up third down and 7. He was starting to go somewhere, but he gets stumped. Oh, come on, that was a cheap shot. That's why I love this guy. And so do the fans. The offense lost another quarterback on the previous play and have only 2 left before they have to forfeit.
Yeah, but on the bright side, Grim, they save a ton of money by not having to pay those guys anymore. The funeral expenses, that is.
And it's first and 10. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
Yeah, sounds like my offseason.
And they quickly call a timeout to stop the clock. And that'll bring up second and 1. Hit arrives right on time. When it's your time to go, it's your time. The quarterback is controlling the clock like the clock is into it. I know I am. And it's first and 10. Ladies and stealing their savings.
That sounds like a good job.
He's right at home here taking money from coaches, players, and fans.
I even saw him swiping money from the bathroom attendant.
Hey, who don't do that?
Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner.
On one,
and there's an 8-yard catch.
Chipping away with those medium passes, I like it. Like a patient prison break.
And that'll be their final timeout. And the offense goes into their 2-minute drill.
Which coincidentally happens to be Brent's match stupsing time.
That's why the girls call me Speedy Gonzalez.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
And it's first and 10. Boom! And like the Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got that mutant bingo. All I need is 77 to fight it.
Yeah, you think you can go toe-to-toe with me? Well, you're mistaken, man. You get up my grill, I'm gonna ruin your world. I'm gonna wreck it.
And they line up for the extra point. Straight through the uprights. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and ten. Winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks. Boom, dead and down. Nothing more to say about this guy except maybe a eulogy.
Well, he was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But, he was a great ball player. That's really what counts at the end of the day, right?
And the quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out. Another pick. And, oh man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're gonna hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor.
Man, nobody better shot my ball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
The second quarter comes to a close as the teams head for the locker room, and we take you to halftime. Brought to you by Monsanto Industries. We make genetically engineered food that is to die for. It's the start of the third quarter, and we are set to go, Bricks.
Oh, boy! Where are we going, Grim? A carnival? Huh? I'm gonna go to a striptease show. Where are we going?
Hey, why don't you settle down? Just pet your rabbit, Lenny. Just pet your rabbit. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chick wearing a wig.
And it's first and ten. He heard footsteps, so he tossed the ball out of bounds. Good move. Second down and 10.
Don't worry. If he shot...
Oh, he took a leap and hit the ball, knocked out. Fumble.
He's got a case of fumbleitis.
Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! And it's first and ten.
Hot one.
Oh, man, his neck vertebrae just got crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting on a bag of potato chips. As they say at the deli, who's next?
Can I get a Swiss on rye with no mustard?
Yeah. left. You need to conserve those runners now and consider passing more. Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sick.
Straight through the uprights. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
Boom, dead and down.
He delivered the freaky fast ham sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
No, still working on my salami here, Briggs. Thanks.
That's what she said. Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep. At this rate, the QB's gonna have more interceptions than completions. Bricks, you gotta love them. Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the MFL. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot eight.
Put that guy out of his misery and says, who's next? He's at the 10. It's a touchdown. The offense must forfeit the game because all our quarterbacks are dead. There's no one left to throw the ball, so this game is over.
Well, that's one way to win a game. Kill all the players on the opposing team. Don't seem fair, Grim.
Hey, life's not fair, dipshit. But it's not kicking in the head. It's kicking in the balls.
You know, this should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. Goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Oh, nice hit. And it's first and ten. A catch for 3 yards. Second down and seven. And that's another turnover for the defense. That, my friends, was an all-pro NFL hit.
Hey, you see that move, baby? No, you didn't. You know why? I'm too fast for you. I'm the greatest. The greatest, I tell you.
The Tokyo Terminators terminated the opposing team into a bloody mess, as they are programmed to do. They win by forfeit. There's not much left of the opposition, and the fans are loving it. There was only one way this game was going to end, and that was in a forfeit.
That's not quite true, Grim. The alien spacecraft could have crashed into the stadium and ended the game. How about it?
How about if you shut the hell up right now? We go down to the field and listen to what the MVP has to say. Blitzro with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's game was brought to you by ComCrack Entertainment. They're not happy until you're not happy.